All right, do you shop on Amazon? If you shop on Amazon, anyone apparently can find you. So how can you make it more private and more secure?
There's actually a few quick and easy ways to do it. Joining us now is tech expert Shelly Palmer. First of all, I didn't know that you could even do this. Look somebody up on Amazon, your profile.
Sure. Well, so on Amazon, you have a profile. Mm-hmm. And that profile, if you have a wish list, is how people find you. So if you register for gifts or if you put a wish list together for your birthday, then obviously people can search you. But what you may not know is that Amazon stores an awful lot of stuff about you that you have the right and very easily can limit. So, for example, if you don't want people to be able to see your profile, just like on Facebook or LinkedIn, you can limit what on the profile they can see. You can take, in fact, you can make yourself completely invisible to people on Amazon. And the way you do it is just go to the settings menu.
The privacy settings?
There is a whole set of privacy settings that most people don't deal with. Other things you can do that are kind of interesting is if you have an Alexa and you're all worried that Alexa's listening to you, right?
Yeah.
Well, Alexa's only really listening to the commands you give it, but if you want to delete those, that's where you go. You go into the privacy, say, I want to delete all of the Alexa phrases I've ever said, and you can just completely delete them and make them unavailable to Amazon so they can't analyze them. You can also make all of your lists private. So if you decide that you have a wish list, but you really want it to be your private wish list and you don't want anyone to be able to find it, make it private so that you're, because they all default to public. So when you make a list, it's a public list because they assume it's a gift list. Go in there, change it to private, and it's going to, you know, that's a good way to keep your intended purchases to be seen from other people. And if you want Amazon not to track you at all, there is an actual do not track. Now, Amazon is now enjoying a $2 billion annual sales of advertising.
Sure, I was going to say.
Advertising.
Right. You see
so they
it.
Target advertising. If you don't want to receive targeted advertising on Amazon and you don't want them to track the things you buy, just go in there and say, hey, don't track me. And it's all right in the settings, and it's super easy to do.
I also like this. You said that you can set up a PIN on Alexa, because a lot of us, you know,
yeah,
kids
that's
by
right.
accident order something on Alexa, and it shows up at the doorstep, and you're like, what's that?
So I won't say, you know, I want to order blah, blah, blah,
yeah.
and Alexa, I won't tell you the right sequence because it'll trigger people out there. But yes, you can set a purchase PIN number, and you should. If you're a Prime member, you definitely should set your Prime PIN number. And if you are an Alexa user and you want to limit orders, you can set a PIN number so that no one can order on your Alexa except for someone with the PIN. Privacy, look, it's not that this is good, bad, or indifferent. It's just that everyone always gets upset when they don't know.
Right.
I didn't know I could do this.
You don't know how that information is being used and who's looking at it. So if you don't have a wish list, you're not public? People
can't
search
you? You can be found, but there's nothing for them to see.
Yeah, okay.
Right, so again, this is, I don't want to make much ado about nothing, but I do want everyone to know that you can go into Amazon, and if you are a list maker, make sure your lists are just for you. And if you want them to be public because you're having a party or you're having an event, go ahead and make them public and let people know about them. But it's, I think it's important for in this day and age, if you don't want to be advertised to, if you don't want to be tracked, you have to know that Amazon's respectful of that, and there's an easy way to solve for it.
I think the bottom line, like you keep saying all the time, go into your privacy settings and make sure you understand what's going on there, because default is public.
Almost always. And default is always they can use the data for anything that's in their terms of use, which nobody reads. They just click.
We just click.
Yeah.
I agree. You're right. We're all guilty of that.
It's kind of a double-edged sword, though, because part of why I use Amazon so much is it does save my information and it makes it really easy. But
I'm not saying you shouldn't do that. And I'm not saying they abuse it in any way. And that's a very important point. Amazon is an incredibly responsible user of your data, and they share it with nobody.
Right.
They
Thank
literally
you.
Share it with nobody. But you need to know.
Yep.
You can do it if you want to.
And you're always in the know. Shelly Palmer, we thank you so much for all the information that you pass along to our viewers.